Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas. From the flight deck. La Crosse Regional Airport is a medium-sized, multi-use airport located just north of La Crosse, Wisconsin. The airport consists of three runways, 1836, 422, and 1331, all that intersect twice. The taxiway system provides access to the commercial terminal and general aviation parking areas located on the west side, and the FBO and the resident hangars located on the southeast side of the airport. The normal traffic consists of air carrier, charter, military, and general aviation. The diverse experience levels of the pilots utilizing La Crosse Regional Airport makes it a challenging environment for both pilots and controllers. One look at the airport diagram, AD, and the first issue pilots should be aware of jumps right out at you. Hotspot 1 indicates the approach end of runway 4. It is concerned with aircraft taxiing to runway 4 or 36. When taxiing south on taxiway Charlie and instructed to hold short runway 36, pilots sometimes miss the fact that the hold short lines and signage are located a significant distance back from the approach end of runway 36. The reason for this becomes clear upon further inspection of the airport diagram. The hold short points not only protect runway 36, but they protect aircraft approaching runway 4 or departing runway 22. This holds true when taxiing from the southeast side of the field to runway 4 or the west side parking areas. The hold short lines that protect runway 4 are on taxiway Alpha 1 short of runway 1836. Another concern in this area of the airport is the close proximity of the approach ends of runways 4 and 36. Aircraft approaching to land have mistaken or fixated on the wrong runway and tried to land. This occurs most often on left downwind for runway 36 and right downwind for runway 4. Pilots see the other runway first and assume that that is their runway. It has also been suggested that the surrounding terrain may contribute to incorrect runway end identification and pilot disorientation. To help pilots identify the correct runway, the runway end identifier lights, or reels, for runway 36 are turned on whenever it is in use. Simply being aware that this potential situation exists will go a long way in avoiding this error. Another area of concern. Taxiway Charlie at runway 31 has no signage to indicate where the taxiway is located. Pilots must use extreme caution when landing runway 31 and are instructed to turn left at taxiway Charlie. The taxiway is located just west of runway 1836, and turning too soon could inadvertently place your aircraft on an active runway. While focused on this area of the airport, another less frequently occurring issue needs to be addressed. Aircraft holding short of runway 36 at Alpha 1 for departure on runway 4 may receive the following clearance.
Centurion 39 Quebec, proceed on runway 36 at Alpha 1, runway 4, cleared for takeoff.
39 Quebec will proceed on runway 36 to runway 4.
This may seem a bit confusing. However, a quick look at the AD or moving map should make this clearance clear and understandable. Hotspot 2 is located at the intersection of Alpha, Bravo, and Alpha 3, and highlights the potential for pilot confusion due to the complexity of the pavement layout. In addition, because this intersection is close to the runways, disorientation at this location can present a risk of a runway incursion. The use of moving map displays or the airport diagram will help pilots mitigate this sort of hazard. While these are the main areas of concern, there are several more unique aspects to La Crosse that pilots flying in for the first time need to be aware of. In the winter season, runway 422 is closed because the airport does not plow it. Check NOTAMS if you plan to fly during the winter season. If pilots park at the FBO located on the southeast side of the airport, please be aware that the tower has limited visibility in that area and may not be able to see you when you call for taxi. Pilots need to exercise additional vigilance for surrounding traffic when operating in this area. Pilots must ensure a complete understanding of taxi instructions prior to taxiing. This will prevent you from exiting the FBO ramp on a route not expected by ATC. The FBO ramp at times can get very congested, and if you are unable to comply with the provided taxi instructions, you must coordinate with ATC for an alternate route. Additionally, when taxiing from the FBO ramp, pilots need to be aware of the relatively short distance from the ramp to the hold short lines for runway 36 on taxiway Alpha 1. Taxi clearances at La Crosse can sometimes be complex and include multiple runway hold short instructions. Pilots need to be absolutely clear on these requirements, when and where they are to hold short, and when and where they are cleared to cross. If you are not sure of your clearance, hold short and ask the tower. A few seconds for verification are well worth avoiding a possible incursion or worse. The last taxi issue concerns taxiway Delta, located between runway 1836 and runway 422. When cleared to hold short of either runway on Delta, pilots need to ensure that they are clear of the other runway behind them, as well as ensure that they are holding short of the assigned runway in front of them. If your aircraft overhangs either of the hold short lines, either in front of or behind your aircraft, you are not considered protected from the runway movement area. If your aircraft size puts you in this situation, you must advise the tower as soon as possible so that alternate instructions can be provided. This will help the tower keep the traffic flow safe and efficient for all users. One last item pilots need to be aware of is the fact that La Crosse does not have radar in the tower for either airborne or ground operations. This means that controllers rely on accurate position reports from pilots approaching the airport, in the pattern, and on the ground. Providing accurate position information to the tower will help the controllers provide better service to all aircraft at and around the airport. Pilots need to remember that if they are ever in doubt or unsure of any instruction or aircraft position, the easiest answer is to ask the tower. They are there to help. Being aware of the hot spots and other configuration issues at La Crosse will help pilots make better decisions, and along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. Now, you're better prepared for your trip to La Crosse Regional Airport. It's always better to know before you go.